Hello friends, welcome to my channel Learning for Life. So today we are going to see balanced diet. This is the continuation of the previous topic, components of food lesson. So we are going to see what is balanced diet. Whatever the food you eat from morning to night, so that is your diet in a day. So like for you to grow, you have to grow, right? From when you are in childhood, you would have been in very small. When you become an adult, you would have become little higher height, little height you would have grown up. So like this, for growth and maintenance of your body health, you need all types of nutrients in proper amount. So one nutrient should not be less and the other nutrient should not be high. So we need all type of nutrients in proper amount. All the nutrients like carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals, proteins, fats. So all these nutrients present in proper amount is your balanced diet. I hope you'll understand. So this is your balanced diet. Next is, do you think that all people of all ages need the same food, same type of food? Is it so? Does a child and an old woman require the same kind of nutritious food? Is it so? Definitely not, because a child need weight gain. Child has to eat a lot and need weight gain. Whereas an elderly person, they would have followed some medication due to their disease. And they should be very cautious in their food. So, people of all ages cannot have same kind of food. So, this is it. And then, if you prepare a chart, what are the different types of food you eat in a day, and then you collect for every week, and you collect for month, and then you prepare and analyze yourself the type of vitamins and nutrients you take in a day or a month. Okay, so next, if you see, means this sprouted seeds, pulses, groundnuts, soya beans, and etc. Many examples are given. So these seeds gives you enough nutrients needed for your body. Next one, enough nutrients needed for your body. So it is not enough that you eat the right kind of food. It is also important that you eat the food which is rich in vitamins, minerals. It is not that you eat right kind of food enough in nutrients. It is also important that the nutrients that you eat in the food should not get lost. So if you see washed, what I mean is, the vegetables and fruits, after cutting or peeling them, if you wash it, some of the minerals and vitamins present in them get lost. So what is the use of eating it? You need vitamins and minerals to get energy and you have to work, right? So some of the vitamins and minerals get lost if you wash the vegetables and fruits after cutting or peeling them. Next one, if you remove the skin, otherwise if you wash the skin of the vegetables and fruits very much, again the minerals and vitamins will get lost. So many skins of vegetables and fruits contains more vitamins and minerals. Okay, so that if you wash more vigorously, it gets lost. But we have to wash it, right? Human tendency is to wash it well. But you know, this is a fact that if you wash it well, the skins of fruits and vegetables, the vitamins and minerals will get lost. Okay. For example, they said rice and pulses. So rice and pulse, if you wash more number of time, the vitamins and minerals present in them will get lost. So also, only if you cook the food, it will add taste for eating, right? Are you able to eat the raw, every vegetable as raw, as raw material you are able to eat? No, right? So excess water, so you are going to cook the vegetable, but if you are adding excess water, again the vitamins and minerals will get lost. So not only this, it requires vitamin, minerals and all the nutrients, but also our body needs roughage. Why our body needs roughage? In order to get rid of undigested food, we saw already. So roughage is needed by our body, and water is also needed by our body. So these are all the type of nutrients in proper amounts is known as balanced diet, and we saw how the minerals get lost by washing. So next one, Bujha. Bujha thought that he is one person. He thought that whatever I eat, it should be fat, because fat gives much more energy. So I am going to eat only fat. Likewise, he ate fat and fat for a long period of time, and then he started gaining weight, and he was suffering from obesity. You know what is obesity, right? Obesity means suffering from gaining weight. That is more weight. That is obesity. So next one, it is deficiency disease. What is deficiency disease? Deficiency disease is lack of vitamins and minerals in your body. Like it results for a long period of time, results in deficiency, and it will cause you disease. So that is known as deficiency disease. This is overall. So a person will be getting enough food to eat, but the food may not contain a particular type of nutrient. Likewise, the person is eating the food for 6 months. Okay, so like this, the person eating the food for 6 months without getting enough nutrients, it results in deficiency. So that is deficiency. So lack of proteins in your food. So if you are eating a food and the food does not contain protein, it may result in stunted growth, discoloration of hair. Stunted growth means the person will not grow after a certain height. Okay, you would have seen some persons who is very small in height. So stunted growth, discoloration of hair. Hair will become white or grey, like that. Discoloration of hair. And then many diseases it will cause. Okay. Next one, if the food does not contain carbohydrates and proteins, it will cause, it will stop the growth of the body, and then your body will become very weak, very thin, very lean, weak, thin and lean, and you are not able to move. So this will cause because of lack of carbohydrates and proteins in our body. So more table, in table 2.3 they have given more loss of, if this vitamin is not there, then what happened, like that it is not given. You can go through it in a book. So deficiency disease prevented by taking. So how to prevent deficiency disease? By taking balanced diet. Okay, why we call it as balanced diet means, likewise if like Bujhu, you are eating more amount of fat. For example, cheese, milk, likewise you are taking it more quantities. So it will result in obesity, right? So that's all. With this, like this, the food is distributed all over the world. So with this, we conclude the chapter, components of food. Thank you, friends. Thanks for watching. If you like my channel, please subscribe, comment and watch. Thank you.